Dear students, I welcome all of you in the another session of transportation engineering. So we have learned various aspects of highway transportation. We have learned what is alignment, what are the types of alignment, what are the factors that affect the highway alignment. We have also learned the Nagpur road plan and where the basics of highway transportation or road transportation have been covered. Now in one of the sessions I had discussed about the thing that is called as DPR. Do you remember the full form of DPR? The full form of DPR is Detailed Project Report. So I had mentioned at that time that the preparation of DPR plays an important role, and without preparing the DPR, the construction of major highway, execution of major highway construction cannot be deployed. So in this session what we are going to do is we are going to learn that how the project preparation takes place and what is DPR and what are the certain aspects of DPR. We have learned that there are total four kind of things that are included in DPR. Those things vary, but these things are fixed. Economic studies are there, then financial studies are there, then technical studies are there, and then environmental studies are there. These things are also called as economic feasibility of project, financial feasibility of project, technical feasibility of project, and environmental feasibility of project. Now we have already learned that what has been covered in economic criteria, then what are the criteria that has been covered in financial, in environment. Now what we are going to learn is, we are going to learn that how the project preparation takes place. The first thing is that why project preparation is required, what it should have, and how to prepare this project preparation report and DPR. The first thing is about why. Why project preparation is required? So project preparation is required to be assured about the feasibility of particular project, that the project that we are going to take place, we are going to consider, is feasible or not. So to be assured about the feasibility of project, and to ascertain the cost estimation, that okay, this is how the extreme cost can be of this particular project. Then to check whether this project is financially viable, whether we will have the sufficient amount of fund to make this project happen, whether this project will play an important role as far as socio-economic criteria is concerned, the betterment of people is concerned, then the time assessment, that how much time will be taken for the execution of this project, and what kind of benefits will be there for the community which is residing in the vicinity of that particular area. So the answer why is to ascertain the time, ascertain the cost, ascertain the feasibility, ascertain the financial and economic feasibility, ascertain the community benefits, and also to have the administrative approvals. If we do not prepare project preparation report, DPR is not prepared, then it will be difficult for us to get the administrative approvals from various government departments, to get the financial loan approvals, to get the technical approvals and financial sanction for the project. Most importantly, success of any project and accrual of project benefits to the community lies in the sound of project preparation. Means the major key of success is the accuracy of the data collection, and all these data are collected and they are prepared in form of report. What it should have? So let me tell you that in the project preparation report, there must be the description of the project, description of the site, then the socio-economic appreciation of the project, then primary and secondary database. We will discuss about the glimpse of primary and secondary database and the socio-economic appreciation also. Okay. There are total three phases. First is about pre-feasibility phase, then about feasibility phase, and then it is detailed engineering, because that report that is also called as detailed project. The scope means, here the scope means the boundary of the project. It does not mean the opportunity. Scope means the boundary, that okay, this project will only be limited up to this area. So this scope is decided by judicially by the government and is as per the requirements. It need to have proper adequate fund, proper planning, absolute control over the data collection, data validation should be there, realistic and factual appreciation should be there, sound project structuring should be there, and quality assurance should be there. Now, how to prepare? So the study initiation involves identification and mobilization of team that will work on this particular thing. Then periodical meetings are gathered of the team, then how the project preparation will take place, project site visits also take place, then the assembling and review of available data is done, that okay, what kind of data is available currently, what kind of development plans are there available in existing. Then there is the formulation of basic design standard, that okay, this is the minimum standard for particular thing, below this standard would not be there. So the minimum quality standard, design standard is prepared, and the action plan is prepared. Then the assembling and review of available data and development plans include various kind of data. The data involves topographical map, then demographical profile, then what kind of male gender people are there, female candidates are there, what are the climatic conditions, what kind of forests are there, what is the past traffic census data there, geographical information of the corridor, then the local schedule of rates means SOR. SOR means what is the price of various kind of materials that are being available on that particular region, that is called as SOR, that is called as schedule of rates, that is decided by the particular roads and building department for particular area, if we are talking about national highway and the stretches. Then GTS benchmark, through which we will be able to know the exact place, the benchmark for that particular location, what are the kind of pavement composition there, then the development plans of various governmental agencies. Study initiation. Then in the formulation of basic design standard, what involves is the geometric elements, stopping site distance, overtaking site distance, pavement materials, bridge and cross drainage work, junctions, service road, bypasses, toll plaza, grade separators are there, traffic signals are there, road markings are there, traffic signs, bus stops, roadside amenities, highway lighting. So various kind of things are there that are being included in the basic design standards. Then if we talk about the field surveys and investigations, so reconnaissance and socio-economic appreciation is done. And traffic studies have also been conducted, such as classified traffic volume count, means what kind of vehicles are traveling in which amount, means how much two-wheelers are passing, how many light motor vehicles are passing, how many trucks are passing, how many cars are passing, based on the PCU also. The directional count is also there. The origin and destination studies, and on the basis of origin and destination studies, the desired lines are plotted, that okay, these are the road and the major traffic goes from this place to this place, so these are the desired lines. Then turning movement surveys are conducted, speed and delay surveys are conducted, in which the spot speed, average speed, journey speed, running speed are there. Then what is the amount of pedestrian traffic count is there, parking surveys are there, registration plate survey, axle load survey, all these surveys are done, and these are the part of field surveys and investigation. All this data are collected. Then how to prepare the field surveys and investigation? So engineering surveys and investigations takes place, which involves embankment beam deformation, then subgrade characteristics of the existing pavement, roughness survey of the pavement is done, geotechnical investigation and subsoil exploration, that okay, if on this stretch the roads are going to be constructed, then what kind of soil capacity is there, what kind of road condition is there, what kind of pavement condition is there, what kind of construction materials are there, what is the availability of construction materials are there, all these things are also concerned in engineering surveys. Then environmental and social assessment takes place. In this socio-economic assessment and environmental assessment, the region is analyzed with respect to various environmental policies, that okay, whether the stretch is passing from any kind of environmental protection zone or not. If the stretch is passing from that zone, then there are two things. We need to have the permission from the environmental department, and if they do not permit, then we have to change our stretch from that place. We cannot use that stretch. Then socio-economic assessment takes place. Social assessment involves what kind of benefit that people will be getting after construction of this highway. For that, benefit cost ratio is calculated. If the value of benefit cost ratio is less than one, then the project is not feasible. It should be more than one. Benefit cost ratio means the benefit in form of quantitative benefits are calculated in the numerator. Benefits that are going to be help to the people which are residing in that area where the highway is going to be constructed. And the cost involves the total construction cost. If the ratio of this thing occurs to be less than one, then it is not feasible. Then the development of street maps are also there. Then the database creation and analysis takes place. The computerization of the collected data takes place. The data is analyzed. Traffic analysis is done, engineering analysis is done, environmental and social impact assessment is done, reconnaissance and socio-economic appreciation is done, because we have collected all this data by going visiting field, collecting data. Now all this data is gathered in the computer system and all this data is analyzed. And with the help of these, the preliminary and detailed designs and drawings are prepared for the road geometry, improvements, pavement design, cross domain structure, other facilities. Then the land acquisition and utility plan is also there. It involves the land acquisition requirement and utility plan that, okay, this kind of utilities such as electricity line, then gas lines will be there. Land acquisition plays an important role. I had already mentioned in the factors affecting road alignment that if the land acquisition issues are not solved before the execution stage, then it will cause hindrance for the process. Because land acquisition is a very time consuming and laborious process, because if your stretch is passing from any of the cultivated area or any of the, what I can say, habitants area, then the people will not allocate their land to us. So before initiating the process, the land acquisition issues should be solved. Then cost assessment also takes place, that involves the quantification of cost, finalization of the unit rates and the assessment. Economic analysis takes place, such as vehicle operating cost, then construction cost, maintenance cost, accident cost, social and environmental cost, project benefit cost. All these things are included in the economic analysis. Then the financial analysis takes place, in which all the projects are compiled, the primary project revenue stream is identified, and the financial analysis is done. Highway Development and Management 4, that is the name of the system or software, that is also used number of times, that is called as HDM4. Then comes the project implementation strategy, in which final recommendation of the project implementation strategy takes place. Then the model analysis framework is prepared, that involves the feasibility study of any of the stretch, such as the feasibility study for the access control corridor between Ahmedabad and Rajkot, that is one of the example of that. So this is how the data is collected, project apparatus, then comes the alignment data, then the preliminary design, then comes the social and environmental aspects, then comes the economic analysis, and then comes the financial. So this is the list of the area that is going to be affected, and these are the various kind of things. This is the framework for the analysis. See, various kind of data that are going to be, that is going to be used is like this. This is the framework of the analysis. This involves in the project appreciation. Then comes this traffic forecast and alignment, then this involves the primary survey, this involves the street maps, and then this involves the economic and financial analysis. See, this is the financial analysis. This is how the system is developed. I would like to thank the team of Lee Associates South Asia Private Limited and Mr. Sagar Deshmukh sir for providing the guidance for this particular thing. And the credits of this presentation goes to LASA, Lee Associates. Thank you so much. I hope you have understood the various processes involved. See, this is the basic glimpse of how the project preparation takes place. Once you visit the site, once you join any consultancy, then you will be able to learn all these things in detail. As the preparation of DPR consumes more than 8 months, it can range up to 2-3 years also, a number of times. And I have tried to compile all these things in the one session because this is just the introductory session of DPR. So I hope you understood the concept thoroughly. Thank you.